Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that is liquidity versus solvency. Are they two the same thing? I guess not. There is a difference between them. So let's understand the difference and see what is exactly going on around with liquidity and solvency. See, before making any investment, it's very important to know two factors upfront: whether the investment will maintain the liquidity of the company and whether the investment of the company is making would keep solvency of the company. There are two statements. I'll again repeat. The two factors: whether the investment will maintain the liquidity of the company and whether the investment the company is making would keep the solvency of the company intact. Okay. So many investors overwhelm themselves with the meaning of liquidity and solvency. So as a result, they use these terms interchangeably. However, these two are entirely different from each other. See, liquidity can be defined, L and S over here. Liquidity basically can be defined as the firm's ability to meet the current liabilities of the current assets it has. Okay. Liquidity is basically the short-term concept, you can say, and also one of the most important one, because without liquidity the firm won't be able to pay off its immediate liabilities. Okay, so we use this ratio like current ratio, your current ratio, we use quick ratio, we use cash ratio, which is known as your CR, to determine the liquidity of the company. But when we talk about your solvency, solvency on the other hand can be defined as the ability of the firm to run its operation in the long run. That means solvency is a long-term concept, as simple as that. And the investment can affect both of this, but they are much different. There is much difference, different than each other. Both of them are different from each other. So let's learn liquidity versus solvency in infographics manner. Now, as you can see that each of these concepts are much different, here the most significant difference that is between the liquidity and the solvency. So let's understand from this infographics, liquidity versus solvency. The first that we're going to understand is the meaning. Liquidity can be defined as the ability of the firm, we have just discussed, to pay off its current liability with the help of its current assets. While solvency is basically the level of situation or ability of the firm to operate, to run the business for a longer period of time. Now, second point of difference, what it's all about. Liquidity, it's a short-term concept, absolutely, because liquidity in itself involves what? Your current assets and your current liability. And when these two things are involved, absolutely, the liquidity has to be short-term concept in nature, and it because cash and cash equivalents to pay off its current debt. While solvency, it's a long-term concept of how well the operations of the firm would run. So this is the second point of difference. The third point of difference that we are going to understand is the obligations. Now, liquidity, it has a short-term obligation because it involves current assets and current liability. While solvency, it has a long-term responsibility. Now, the fourth point of difference, why understand this? Liquidity, it is basically to know how fast the current assets can be converted into cash, as simple as that. Now, what about solvency? It is basically whether the firm can perpetuate again and again, year after year, whether it can stay solvent, whether it can be a going concern situation, whether the company is in a going concern case or not. So it's going to perpetuate again and again, year after year. Then fifth, risk. Now, over here, in case of current assets and current liability, the risk is really very low because everything will be on a short-term note, everything will get converted. But in case of the solvency, the risk is really high. And absolutely, you cannot deny the fact. What to look into balance sheet? Now, current assets and current liability, we now know very well whenever we talk about liquidity term, current assets and current liability have to come into picture. And the detailed account of every items beneath them under current assets and current liability. But when we talk about solvency, solvency is all about the company's shareholding patterns, that is shareholders' equity, what is the amount of debt it is holding, any long-term assets, if any, So all those are some of the solvency criteria. Now, what are the ratios used? We just discussed current ratio and the quick ratio, which is also known as your asset test ratio for liquidity purpose. But when we talk about solvency, debt to equity ratio. Now, debt to equity ratio is one of the key measure for your solvency. Interest coverage ratio. There's one more called DSCR ratio, that is debt service coverage ratio. In finance industry, DSCR ratio is very famous and it is the most renowned one in case of the interest and the debt coverage. So these are some of the ratios which are the key drivers determinants of the solvency. Impact of each other. When we talk about liquidity, if solvency is high, liquidity can be achieved absolutely and within a short period of time, because solvency will lead to your liquidity. But if liquidity in over here, if liquidity is high, solvency may not be achieved very quickly. Absolutely, that it's undoubtable fact that we cannot deny it. Now, let's understand the key differences between L and S, that is your liquidity and your solvency. When we talk about the key differences, as you can, you know, we just already saw liquidity and solvency cannot be interchanged and they are completely different from each other. Let's look at some of the key differences between liquidity and solvency. See, liquidity can be defined as the firm's ability to pay its current liability with the help of the current assets. And solvency, on the other hand, is an individual or the firm's ability to pay off its long-term debt in on a long-term note. Second, liquidity is basically the short-term concept, while your solvency is basically your long-term concept. A third point of difference, liquidity can be found out by using the ratios like current ratio, quick ratio, and over here we have the ratio like debt to equity ratio, and we have a ratio like a DSCR ratio or interest coverage ratio and interest coverage, not or. Concept-wide, liquidity has a low risk, you can say, and over here, high risk, right? Liquidity needs to be understood to know how quickly a firm would be able to convert its current assets into cash, and solvency, on the other hand, talks about whether the firm has the ability to send the cash flow for the long period of time. So based on this, after understanding all the differences and the key differences, let me finally conclude on this note. As you can see, you know, liquidity and solvency both are very important concept, absolutely, for a business, but they cannot be used interchangeably because they are completely different in their nature, in their scope, okay, and in case of their purpose, right? Liquidity can basically ensure, you know, whether the firm will pay off its immediate debt, and solvency, on the other hand, you can say that on the other hand, handles the long-term debt and the firm's ability to perpetuate. So once you understand these concepts, you would be able to become a prudent analyst. So you would also be able to make a quick and an effective decision about any next move that you are supposed to take for your business.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.